What up, everyone? It's your boy Marky Mark, your host for Pinoy Crossover tonight here at Jurassic Park for Game 6, Raptors versus the Warriors. I'm so excited about this game. Unfortunately, we couldn't make it past the Warriors on Game 5, but we're here and we know that we're gonna give everything we got for the Raptors. We're here live at Jurassic Park. We're gonna get some interviews and some insights from the people here live, the real fans at Jurassic Park. So stay tuned, guys. It's your boy Marky Mark here, Pinoy Crossover. Over here on my side, we got Jay Skeets from the Starters. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm ready. I'm excited. I can barely hear you right now because they're getting the energy going in here in Jurassic Park, but I'm very, very excited for this game, yeah.
Awesome. Tell me about your thoughts about Game 5. I want to hear, you know, how did you thought about it?
I mean, Game 5, that was one for the ages in terms of just being so weird with the Kevin Durant injury and even whether or not he was going to play heading into that game and then him playing and him getting injured again and was the crowd cheering or were they, you know, were they booing, whatever. And then a game unfolded, which was close, but Warriors pulled out. They hit those three threes late and the Raptors, look, I was in the building and when the Raptors went up 6 points, that place was celebrating like they had won the championship. So it was a little premature. Warriors, look, the Raptors are going to have to steal and take the championship from the Warriors. They're not just going to give it to them. So we go to Game 6 now here for Oakland. And the Raptors, you got to like their chances on the road. They played really well there. And worst case scenario, they get a Game 7 at home. And that's why you have the better record. That's why you want a good record when you go into the playoffs.
Tell me about your thoughts about the Jurassic Park. What separates the Raptors fans and this kind of environment from other teams out there in the NBA?
I mean, it's incredible. I got a guy like making Raptor sounds behind me right now. These people, they're diehards. They are diehard fans. And they are now, they are making this a thing across the NBA. You are going to see Jurassic Parks pop up in other cities, new arenas especially, to have this sort of communal viewing party and excitement and just the energy that it brings to a team and to a city. But yeah, the Raptors set the tone. So it's really cool for me because I grew up a Raptors fan day one when there was a loyal but very small fan base. And now it's just exploded into this. And it's a party even when the team's on the road.
Game 6, what do you think the Raptors need to do to win this game?
Well, I mean, you're going to try your best to slow down Steph Curry and Klay Thompson. You're going to try and run them off the three-point line if you can. You'll live with them hitting twos. You'll live with them sometimes getting to the rim. Avoid open three-point shots because when they hit 15-plus, they're basically money. It's a guaranteed win. So they're going to want to try and prevent that from happening. And the other thing is, you know, Kawhi usually comes out after a loss and puts up big numbers. Who's going to help him? Is it going to be Lowry? Is it going to be Gasol? Is it going to be Siakam? Someone has to sort of help Kawhi out on the offensive side of the ball. So, you know, again, I think I like the confidence of the Raptors heading in here to try and win this on the road. So it's going to be a close game, and whoever makes the big shots down the stretch is going to come away with it.
Last question. Anything you want to say to the Filipinos out there that are big fans and Raptors, and not just Raptors, but NBA fans in general?
Yeah, real talk, the Filipinos, their fans are crazy about the NBA, the Raptors fans out there as well, but they have always supported our show. They love the show. People want us to go do a tour there, and we want to do that because we know just how diehard basketball fans they are out there. So much love to all you people in the Philippines for not only watching our show, supporting us, but just for being a basketball fan. You picked the right sport because I know it's basically the national sport there, and you're smart, and I love that.
Awesome. Thank you so much, JCs. We appreciate it.
Take care, man.
What up, everyone? It's your boy Marky Mark. We're here with our, you know, often frequent guests from our show, Pinoy Crossover. We got friends, the boy Manila. We got three-point shooter Rice Mamba right here. How you feeling?
Hey, feeling pretty good.
Yeah. Tell us about, because you know, we went on Monday together.
Right.
What are your thoughts about the Jurassic Park? Like, what is it? What does it feel like differentiate from watching it here, being with the people here, compared to watching it at home, watching it like, you know, at the stadium?
You know, watching it here, you know, it's much more exciting. You feel the experience with, you know, the fans here. And if they win the finals, you know, they're going to party hard. You know, you definitely know that.
Give us your thoughts about Game 5 because we watched it together. What are your thoughts about it?
You know what? I expected Raptors to win in Game 5. It was a big heartbreaker. They should have won that game, but hey, we got two more chances. Hopefully tonight's the night.
Tell us a little bit about you in basketball. When did you start playing basketball and who did you idolize or who did you really, what team or player that you watch and grew up playing?
All right, so I've liked basketball since I was a little kid. And You know, I idolized Vince Carter, you know, and Kobe Bryant, obviously. I used to watch PBA as well in the Philippines. So I used to watch all the legends, Kaidik, Patrimonio, all those guys, you know, they're PBA legends, basically. Until now, I'm still a huge fan. I'm just glad we're here in the NBA Finals in Toronto.
When did you become a Raptor? So when did you start feeling like Raptors were ever going to get this far, or were ever going to get to this point in their whole franchise?
You know what? To be honest, I never thought in my lifetime we would ever make it to the finals. But now we're here. I'm just glad we're here. We're on the verge of winning a title. I hope they really win it tonight. And, you know, it's going to mean a lot for the city of Toronto.
What do you think they have to do tonight, Game 6, to win it and win the championship?
Sorry, say again.
What do they need to do for Game 6 to win it? What are the keys to the game for them?
Well, they got to keep doing what they're doing. I'm just kidding. Well, they just got to, you know, play defense. They got to prevent, you know, three-point shooting from Steph Curry and Klay Thompson. And they basically have to drive more. They have to be patient like they've always been. And they just have to be poised within all the games that they've won.
Okay, awesome. Last question to all the Filipinos out there. What do you want to tell to them? All the fans that have watched Raptors, NBA in general, basketball. What do you want to say to them?
Let's go Raptors! I'm just kidding. Hey, you know what? Hopefully we win tonight. This is for the Filipino fans. I'm glad we're here. Raps in 6, baby. Let's go.
What up, guys? It's your boy Marky Mark. I'm here with one of the Raptors fan right here, MJ. Tell us a little bit, you know, is this your first or second time here at Jurassic Park? How many times have you been here?
So, this is my second time coming here. The first time I came here was on Monday. I was like, oh, I really gotta go here. So I'm literally like, I really wanna come back here. It just got me hooked coming back here at the Jurassic Park. So I'm so blessed to come in the zone one. It was literally a struggle and stressful just to come in zone one. But I'm so blessed that to be here today.
Right. What are your thoughts about Game 5? Should we have won it? What are you?
Game 5 was pretty upsetting, of course, because I really want this game to be over. It's really stressful because, I don't know, it's just like every day I sleep at 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, and it's just like another job for me to like go work full-time job, go part-time school, full-time Raptors, being a fan. It's just like, I'm just too stoked for it. But anyways, Game 5 was pretty intense. It was my first time being at Jurassic Park, which is pretty awesome. That's why I came back here, and I was aiming to go to Zone 1, so I'm here in Zone 1, so I'm truly blessed. But Game 5, in a way, I feel like, you know, Warriors deserve the win because, you know, as Canadians and Torontos, they, you know, it's not very classy or, you know, polite or nice to, like, you know, boo on someone who, like, got injured, right? So I felt really bad for him. Like, I'm sure everybody felt it too, so, but I hope he gets better, KAD. So, but yeah.
How do you feel? What brings you back here at Jurassic Park? What is it that brings you, you know, from your first one to coming back again, maybe in the future again, and maybe a multiple?
So, in regards to coming back here in Jurassic Park, I just love the energy. I love the energy. I love the people. I love everyone. It's just so awesome that everyone's coming here together as one, you know, as a community, as Toronto, as a nation. We're very multicultural, and I feel so blessed to be born and raised here in Toronto. I'm really grateful that I hope, you know, Raptors really win it because it's so exciting. It's so speechless. So I really hope that Raptors win, but Jurassic Park is so awesome. So I really totally recommend to come here.
So, last thing, for Filipinos out there that are watching the game, what do you want to say to all the Filipinos out there?
Marami salamat po sa lahat sa... I don't know how to speak Tagalog, I'm sorry. But Filipino represent! I don't know what else to say!
All right. Thank you guys, that's all we got. But more, stay tuned.